Okay, the last time I talked to you, I had just finished exercise 16, direction number 8, which was to find the average sales for bestsellers. If you recall, we used the sum if and the count if functions, and then a dividing by right in between them. That gave me the average of not of everything that was sold, but it gave me the average of the best selling items. All right, so that was direction number 8. Let's move on to direction number 9. It says, in cells C34 through C36, use sum if to calculate the total sales for each of the different types of ethnic food. Sounds fine. For example, and now I'm going to do some for example with you. Let's take a look. The different types of ethnic food are Oriental, Italian, Mexican. It's fine. How are these distinguished in this list? Well, let's see. If this thing says the brand name and it says Mexican gourmet food, clearly that's Mexican food. If this one says Oriental seafood, there you are. If this one says gourmet food, there it is. Those are the three categories that we're going to be using in our sum if statement that's about to happen. So let's take a look. The total sales of Oriental. I'm going to say equal sign, sum if, and then I'm going to put the open parentheses. You see here that Excel says, oh, I recognize the function you're doing. Now I want to know the range and the criteria. Remember, these first two items are where is the testing criteria. So I'm going to say the range in which the testing criteria are is right here, the supplier. So I'm going to put it. There it is. That's the range. Okay. Next thing you know, I want the criteria. Well, in this case, the criteria are going to be, well, I want to know if it's Oriental food. So let me put a comma. Let me put some parentheses. And then I'm going to, well, let me see. I'm going to try to do this a little bit differently. All right. I want to correct myself. No, I don't want that. I'm going to say, I'm going to just type it in myself. Chang Li Oriental Food. Here I am. Chang Lo Li Oriental Seafood. Now, the truth is, computers are usually pretty picky. You have to type it in exactly as it is if you want it to pick up on what you're intending. Okay, so I'm going to press the comma. Great. Now the sum range is highlighted. So I'm going to say, where are the numbers that you should add if this criterion is true? Well, they're right here. And it is this range, which is D11 through D25. There they are. Okay, got them. This function is now ready to finish, so I'm going to put the closing parentheses. I'm going to hit enter. There it is. I could go through here, and I could pull out a hand calculator, and I could add up this item, 15,000 and change, and this item, 10,000 and change. So it would be about 25,000, okay? And this thing, that would be about 29,000. This one, that would be about 34,000. This one, that would be about 36,000. So my very rough estimate was 36,000, and the calculated total was 38,000. Yep, I'm pretty sure this came out exactly the way it should have. Let's continue. Let's do the rest. This one, I want the total of Italian food. Once again, I type equal. I type sum if. I have the opening parentheses. Now I have to have the range where it's going to test. And the range it's going to test is right here. What is it going to test for? Well, I want it to add it if it is Italian food, but I have to enter it rather precisely. So here I go. Al dente Italian. G-O-U-R-M-E-T close the parenthesis and put a comma to say I'm done talking about the criterion. There it is. And then now it's telling me on my little guiding hints here that I want to now enter the sum range. Here it is. It's now done. I'm ready to put a close parenthesis and press enter. It says 36,000. Let's find out if I agree. Let's see now. The Italian food, here's one. It's about, well, let's say actually this is closer to 6,000. Okay. 6,000 plus 5 would be 11,000. Plus this would be 15,000. Plus this would make about 30,000. And plus this would make about 36,000. My rough estimate is 36,000, and indeed the calculated sum is very close to that. I'm in good shape. All right, here I go. Mexican food equal sum if open parentheses the range. And now I'm gonna try a shortcut, so I hope you'll bear with me. I'm pressing escape because I want to get out of there for a second. I'm actually gonna take this Mexican food and I'm going to highlight it like that. I'm gonna copy it. Alright? I'm gonna put it down here and just paste it in just to make sure it looks good. Yep, looks good. So here's what I'm gonna try. This is an experiment, we'll see if it works out. Sum if open parentheses, the range. That's the range I want. Comma, quotation mark. Now I'm going to press Control V to see if I get the criterion to show up. I did. I'm pretty happy. Saved me some typing. Close parentheses, comma, and then the sum range, the numbers that should be added if the criterion is true. There it is. And I press close parentheses, and I press enter. Let's see. It says very close to 40,000. Well, I'm going to go back here. You can do it on your own, or you could say, look, if this is the total is about 114,000. Well, if you added these up, that would be about 90. Yep, my rough estimate is correct. I better get rid of this little scrap that I just put there for experiment's sake. That is the end of direction number 9. It says, let's spell check the worksheet, no problem. Texan, I'm gonna leave that alone as because that is some proper name, so I ignore. I could add it if I wanted to, but it's a proper name, I add that. Taquitos, yeah. Okay, I'll spell check the worksheet. I'm not going to print the worksheet, or I might print the worksheet only because I have a print to PDF. I don't want you to use a lot of paper. Please don't go ahead and print if you're going to have to print to an actual physical printer. Me, I use Bullzip PDF printer so that when I print, it actually does not go to a physical printer. Instead, it goes to a file. Let's take a look at what I printed. There it is. It seems to be 1 out of 2 pages. Ah, that's not exactly perfect. I would probably use some formatting. I might decide to print on a landscape or such. But right now, I'm not going to worry too much about that. I'm going to keep going and finish the exercise. Print the worksheet, close the workbook, save all the changes. Well, we better save it. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please save as. And then save it once in your finished work. And then next thing you know, I want you to save it in ready to be handed in to teacher. And make sure you have your name on the end of it. So use the save as function to make sure that you save it where you want to. I'm going to save it right here. This should be my second copy. I'll give you a warning. That's fine. And I'm finished. I'll move on to the next exercise.